So every now and then, a new photo editing tool or feature that I want to cover on this channel aligns with some real world need in my life. Now, sadly, my dad passed away a few months ago, and one of the things that I started doing after that was to scan all of our family photos so that they can be preserved digitally. As I was showing these scanned photos to my mom, she saw one of me when I was a toddler and asked if I could clean it up and print it again for her. When I looked at the photo, I realized that while I could edit it and I had enough resolution to print it at a 4x6, my face lacked sharpness. And that's where the idea for this video popped in my head. I saw that Topaz Labs recently updated Gigapixel 7, their AI-powered upscaling app, to include a second-generation face recovery model that offers 2x the detail and resolution of the first model, while also preserving original facial features. So I thought that this is the perfect opportunity to see how Gen 2 Face Recovery works as I spiff up an almost 45-year-old photo of myself as a little boy. Of course, if you're interested in learning more about Gigapixel AI, I've got a link right down below to check it out. All right, with that, let's dive in. All right, so here we are. This is a photo of toddler Brian. I don't know how old I am here, but I know that I was in Brooklyn, New York, which is where I am from. And you can see that the resolution of this photo, it's about 6 megapixels. It's right over here. And I use this Epson picture scanner. So the whole thing about it is that it can scan photos very quickly. And it did a pretty good job. So this is the photo. And what I want to do is I want to, if we zoom in here, you can see how I want to kind of improve the detail of my face. This is an old photo and you can see it's got noise and stuff, which I'm not as worried about, but I would like to make it look a little nicer for my mom when I give it to her, when I print it for her, whatever she wants. So let's just walk through how I would edit this photo, because here's the thing. It's not like I'll just take this photo and send it to Gigapixel. I think that the reason why I want to do this video is, yes, I will have the opportunity to show you this Gen 2 face recovery model, but you don't normally just take your photo and send it and upscale it. You first want to do a few things to it and then upscale it and then maybe do a few finishing touches. So let's start here with the crop tool. That's the first thing that I want to do. So I'm going to crop in right around here. And actually, I mentioned how I might want to print this at a 4x6, but I think my mom wants it at a 5x7, which should be enough resolution. But what I can do is go to the aspect ratio and then change it here to 7x5, which will ensure that this will be properly formatted for a 7x5 print. So let's go ahead here. We'll position this kind of like this and maybe bring it in a little bit more. I kind of like that little 227 on the stairs here. So something like that. Let's see how that works. That's okay. Let's bring it over a little bit more. And we should be good. Yeah, that's good. Actually, no, I'm going to bring it over even a little bit more. I don't want it to be dead center. I want to be a little bit off center here. So I'm happy with this. The next thing I'm going to do is get rid of some of these various artifacts. Like you can see here, this is something that was on the actual photo print. So I'll clean this up and I'm just going to use the standard content aware remove brush. I know that we have generative remove here. And if you want to learn more about that, I'll leave a link to that video at the end of this one. It's super powerful, but the really important thing that you need to remind yourself is that while generative remove is powerful, it's not always needed. For these kinds of things here, like getting rid of these little spots, just using the regular content aware remove brush is more than adequate. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to speed through this and just get rid of some of this stuff right now. All right, so gotten rid of pretty much all of these things. Actually, I see one more up here that I want to get rid of. And we're good to go for the most part. Now we'll go to the editing tools, and I'm just going to make a few quick edits. Obviously, this is a scan, so I'm not really worried too much about a custom or accurate white balance. I'm going to drop the white point and the highlights down a bit, open up the exposure just a little bit here. Let's drop the black point and the shadows. And I'm not really worried so much about these lines or anything yet, because I want to go through upscaling before I really start to tackle that. Let's go ahead and apply just a little bit of an S-curve here. You know I love my S-curves. It does a really nice job of adding contrast. And I'm going to add a little bit of gray to the shadows there. Okay, we can just see what that S-curve did a really nice job. And then in terms of the temperature, it's a little bit warm, so I'm going to cool that off just a tiny bit just to kind of counter that really warm tone in the image. And let's just add a little bit of vibrance. All right, so that's really all I'm gonna do. If I hit the backslash key, you can see that is the cropped original image. And then this is what we did with kind of getting rid of all of those distractions and doing just kind of like a minor edit over here. So now what I wanna do is I wanna export this to the desktop so that I can open it in Gigapixel 7. Now, right now, if you're using Lightroom Classic, you can just send your photo to Lightroom Classic using the tools there. But currently with Lightroom Desktop, there is no third-party app support, so I'm hoping that will come soon. For now, though, what you'll want to do is export that image to your desktop. So this image is already local. I am using the local tab right now, so I'm going to right-click. I'll go to export one photo, and I'm just going to go to export here. I'll make sure that this is a JPEG. It's full size. I'm bringing it to 100% quality. Custom name here, it doesn't matter. I'm just going to go with original, and then I'm going to keep these other settings default. So then I'm going to click on export one photo. Let's save it to the desktop here. And then if we go to the desktop, you can see there is the new photo that was just exported out. And if we go up here, you can see that is the original and that this is the Lightroom edit. So now what I want to do is open that image up in Gigapixel 7. And I've got Gigapixel 7 right over here. You can see it's version 7.4.2. You'll want to make sure, obviously, that you're updated to the latest version. And I'm just going to take it and drag it on. All right, so the first thing that I like to do is I like to have the before and after side by side. So you can do that by clicking on this icon here. The other thing I do is I select the resize factor. So in this case, I'm going to go and resize it or upscale it by 4x. And you'll see now that we are resized. Let's move the focus box here onto me since I want to make sure that my face is improved. Now, here's the thing. Right off the bat, this actually looks significantly better. But you'll see that we are actually using Gen 1 of Face Recovery. And so Gen 2, this is the new feature in Gigapixel 7. It's in beta. And so what I want to do is I want to use that. So I'm going to click on this. And I think it's significantly better. If we kind of go between the two, so there is Gen 1. You can see there are some artifacts. It looks a little splotchy. When I go to Gen 2, it just looks a lot cleaner. Now, there is this slider down here, and you really want to pay attention to it because I think if you bring it to 100%, it just looks, this looks unnatural. I mean, it's very sharp, but it is way too unnatural. So what I usually do is I kind of bring it back in increments. And I stop until kind of where it looks like there's a good balance between the original and the AI upscaled version. And so this is looking good, but the only thing that I've noticed is that, and this is true with Gen 1 and Gen 2, you see how there's this kind of hard line over here where it's not upscaling the rest of my hair. You can see if I click on select faces to recover, it does find my face. So that's good there, but unfortunately, it's not recovering this. You can see if I go to Gen 1, it's also blurry there. So we'll go to Gen 2. The other thing that I want to highlight is there are two different modes. There's realistic, and then there's also creative. And so it really depends on your aesthetic. For me, I prefer realistic. I think it gives a more realistic look, to be honest. And then in terms of the settings, I'm just using what it recommends for sharpening, denoise, and compression fixing. So I'm happy with that. That's fine. The last thing that, if you want, what you can do is let's go ahead. We'll bring this to full screen and let's kind of zoom it out to fit so we can see the overall image. When you do this, it takes a little bit longer because it's actually processing the entire image. So give it a couple of seconds depending on your computer. But here you can see this is the image. And if I click and hold, you can see that it does do a really nice job. And actually, you can't really tell that line when we zoomed in terms of the soft focus. But one of the things that you can do is you can compare multiple models together. So this is kind of independent of the face recovery. So if I click on compare here, I can select up to four models. So I'm going to select standard, low res, high fidelity, and text and shapes, and click on compare. I'll go ahead and I'll zoom into 200%. Actually, no, that's way too tight. Let's zoom out a bit to 100% and let's put focus box on my face again. And so when I look at these four models, I do think that the low resolution V2 model provides the best results of these four. So I'm going to click on this here. And then on the bottom, I'm going to click on apply model. And so now we're kind of back at where we were with the image. All right, so I'm happy with this here. That I've done everything I wanted. I upscaled it by 4x and I applied this really impressive Gen 2 face recovery model. Let's click on export image. I'm going to save it to the same folder, which is my desktop. I'll preserve the input format and the color space. You can see that we are getting a huge file size increase. So it's going from 2.3 megabytes to 218.6 megabytes. So just something to consider. Also, with the file naming here, you'll see that it's youngbrian-2, which was the file I opened, dash Topaz. You can control that over here under the file name settings. Let's go ahead and click on save. I'll close this window out here. And then on the desktop, this is the original photo. This is the export from Lightroom with those initial edits. And then this is the gigapixel edit. So again, you can see that that's here, here, and then here. Now, if I go to Lightroom and I go to the grid view, you'll see that we have all three images. So watch, if I compare these two images, just to start, let's close out that side panel here. And I zoom in. You can see, first of all, there is a lot more resolution, so that's why it's a lot closer. We'll go ahead, we'll zoom out. Let's go to 200%, and you can see the improvements here. Obviously, again, I have four times the resolution, so when I zoom in, it looks closer. But if we just kind of look at my face over here, and then my face over here, and you can see that it really is an improvement there. So let's drop out of compare mode, we'll go to the upscaled image here. I'm gonna close the film strip and then go to edit here. Now there are a few little kind of artifacts that were sharpened. They were kind of dull, but when we upscaled, when Gigapixel sharpened it, you can see down here, you know, there's just like little stuff that you might want to remove here. You know, you can see there's kind of like right there, little scratches. I'm not going to bother with that right now just because I want to show you kind of some finishing touches, but know that when you bring this back in from Gigapixel, you'll probably want to go through with another fine-tooth comb to do some content-aware or generative remove healing. So now what I'll do is, like I said, I'm just going to add some finishing touches here. I'm going to go ahead and apply just a very, very mild color grade. So I'm going to add a little bit of blue in the shadows here. And I'm going to add a little bit of kind of orange in the highlights to give it a little bit of a cool little kick. I'm going to reduce the luminance of the shadows as well with this slider, and I'm also going to increase the highlight luminance. I'm going to go to color calibration, use the blue primary saturation slider to add a nice little kick right there. Let's add a little bit of clarity, a little bit of texture, and a negative dehaze, because that's going to give it a nice glow overall throughout the image. And then I'm going to wrap things up with a vignette. So something like that. Let's bring that closer to center and increase the feather. And then finally, we'll add some sharpening. So let's zoom in over here. I'll zoom out just a little bit so I can see a little bit more. And then I'll option or alt click while dragging on the amount slider until I see some really nice sharp details there. And then with masking, option or alt click and remove it from areas where it's not needed. And again, like I said, I can spend time removing these spots, which I will, but if I press and hold on the backslash key, not going overboard. Remember, this is like almost a 45-year-old photo. So I do really like this here. And then all that's left to do is export it and send it to the printer. And so I love it when software developers, they don't just release a feature and then forget about it, but they actually work on improving it more and more. Again, this is a second generation face recovery model. So I think it's great that we have that option there. And again, it's one of those things where you probably won't use it if your image already has plenty of resolution. But if you're working with really low res files, like that's something that I'm doing a lot more. Like I said, because I am scanning a lot of my old family photos, apps like Gigapixel, especially because it has this really improved Gen 2 face recovery model, make make my life a lot easier. So that is great. Again, if you want to learn more about Gigapixel 7, I've got a link to that right below. And if you want to learn more, I mentioned about generative remove in Lightroom. Super powerful. Check out this video. If you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated, as is clicking on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.